Hello everyone, I am back with another video. In this video I am going to talk about paradoxes that will blow your mind. The first paradox which I am going to talk about will surely make your head feel dizzy. It is called as dichotomy paradox, derived from Greek philosopher named Zeno. It was created as a proof that universe is singular and change, including motion, is impossible. Now you would be wondering, how is it? But I would tell you that this paradox says to go anywhere, you must go halfway first, and then you must go half of the remaining distance, and half of the remaining distance, and so forth to infinity. Thus the motion will be impossible. From a mathematical perspective, say this is a similar to 0.99 equal to 1, which means there is infinite numbers between 0.99 to 1. So the motion in this case will be impossible, as this paradox says. The next paradox which I am going to talk about will make you think over it again and again. The paradox says, can an omnipotent being create a rock too heavy for itself to lift? While we are at it, how can evil exist if God is omnipotent? And how can free will exist if God is omniscient? These paradoxes exist when you try to apply logic to definitions of God. Some people might cite these paradoxes as reasons not to believe in supreme being, however others would say they are inconsequential or invalid. The next one is surely interesting. It's the crocodile dilemma. If a crocodile steals a child and promises its return, if the father can correctly guess exactly what the crocodile will do, how should the crocodile respond in case that the father guesses that child will not be returned? The crocodile dilemma serves to expose some of the logical problems presented by meta-knowledge. The transaction is logically smooth but unpredictable if the parent guesses that the child will be returned, but a dilemma arises for the crocodile if the parent guesses that the child will not be returned. In the case that the crocodile decides to keep the child, he violates its terms. The parent's prediction has been validified and child should be returned. However, in case that the crocodile decides to give back the child, he still violates his terms even if the decision is based on the previous result. The parent's prediction has been falsified and child should not be returned. The question of what the crocodile should do is therefore paradoxical and there is no justifiable solution. Now the paradox which I want to tell you would be fascinating. It is called as Abelian paradox. In this paradox, a group of people collectively decide on a course of action that is counter to the preferences of many or all of individuals in the group. It involves a common breakdown of group communication in which each member mistakenly believes that their own preferences are counter to the group's and therefore does not raise objections. In simple words, it is the contradiction between the intended purposes of an action and an actual result. Example, members of a group understand problem trying to solve, but they know the steps necessary to achieve outcomes. However, they fail to communicate their individual beliefs to the group. Lack of communication facilitates false agreement, as a result in taking action contrary to what they intended. The next paradox which I am going to tell is related to time travel and is very interesting one. This is called as bootstrap paradox, also called as ontological paradox. You send information or an object to your past self, but you only have that information because in the past you have received it from your future self. This means the information was never created yet still exists. We can see this type of paradox in the Netflix series called as Dark. Predestination paradox. A man travels back in time to discover the cause of a famous fire. While in the building where the fire started, he accidentally knocks over a kerosene lantern and causes a fire, the same fire that would inspire him years later to travel back in time. This is one of my favorite paradoxes, and this paradox can be seen in the movie Predestination, which came in the year 2014, and this film was a masterpiece. The bootstrap paradox is closely related to this result of time travel. Information or objects appear to have no beginning. The next paradox which I am going to talk about, temporal paradox. What happens when a time traveler does things in the past that prevent them from doing them in the first place? Paradox can be seen in various paradoxes such as grandfather paradox. If one travels back in time and kills their grandfather before he conceives one of their parents, which precludes their own conceptions, and therefore they couldn't go back in time and kill their grandfather. This forms an endless loop which will never end. Another type of this paradox is Polchinski's paradox. A billiard ball can be thrown into the wormhole in such a way that it would emerge in the past and knock its incoming past itself away from the wormhole entrance, creating a variant of the grandfather paradox. Hitler's murder paradox. One can travel back in time and murder Adolf Hitler before he can instigate World War II and the Holocaust. But if he had never been instigated that, then the murder removes any reason for the travel. Another kind of paradox we could see in the modern era is twin paradox. Twin paradox involves two identical twins, one of whom makes a journey into space in a high-speed rocket and returns home to find that the twin who remained on the Earth has aged more. This result appears puzzling because each twin sees the other twin as moving. This twin paradox is easily resolved by noting that there is physically meaningful distinction between the experiences of two twins during the trip. The earthbound twin remains in a single constant velocity reference frame the entire time, while traveling twin must accelerate to turn around and come home. The acceleration causes the traveling twin to change from one constant velocity frame to another and produces effects that can be measured locally. As a result of the fact that their experiences are different, there is no prior reason for them to come to the same conclusion. It turns out the result is that the traveling twin is younger upon return than the earthbound twin. This is readily understood from the point of view of the earthbound twin, who remains at all time in a single constant velocity reference frame with reference to the which the traveling twin's clocks are always, except for one instant during the turnaround, running slow. Other than these paradoxes, arrow paradox is another example of dichotomy paradox. This paradox is another of Zeno's arguments against motion. This paradox says that in any instant, a moving object is indistinguishable from a non-moving object. This motion is impossible. The problem here is that at single instant of time, 0 second pass, so zero motion happens. Zeno argued that if time were made of instants, the fact that the motion doesn't happen in any particular instant would mean the motion doesn't happen. These are some of the important paradoxes which I have discussed in this video. And if you like this kind of videos, I will be posting regularly in the future. So do subscribe, share and like this video.